favor.
Being a little starstruck because women who move us, right? Women in support of
that's
women.
That's really sweet. Thank you so much.
Right. To quickly begin with, I would like to understand how's your journey been in the industry as a woman artist?
Well, I think my journey has definitely been very, very different. You know, all the films that I've done have, they don't really fit the conventional form of cinema, or all the characters that have played, they none of them have been your conventional leading actors. And I think it's a great time for an actor like me to be here, because I'm constantly trying to push the boundary. I'm constantly trying to break this mold that has been made for our leading actresses. And it's such great fun. I mean, I'm extremely fortunate to have gotten the parts that I've gotten.
Breaking the stereotypes and how
always it's my personal agenda now too, because it's just so fulfilling as an actor to be able to do that. And you know, when you see people and the audiences love it, and the kind of reaction that they have to your work is phenomenal. Like after every film of mine, my email, my Instagram, my Twitter is just flooded with messages, and not just from women, from men as well. You know, men that are evolved enough to understand that a woman is her equal counterpart, just telling me that how much the film has been loved, the kind of impact it's had on them personally, in their personal life, and it's honestly very, very fulfilling.
And just as you mentioned, you know, even men, you know, like reciprocating to it and like reacting to
yeah.
it. What would you like to say, like, given month of March is especially a highlight, you know, we want to move on from it and celebrate ourselves
yeah.
every day. But what's this one message that you want to give out this Women's Month, if I have to
I
celebrate?
I think the biggest message I want to give out is that we need to first empower ourselves. We can't be dependent on anybody else to come do it. You know, we need to understand, we need to be aware of what our rights are. We need to know that when there is any kind of injustice happening, whether it's with yourself or with somebody in your ecosystem, we need to find the courage to call them out. You know, and once you, and in case you are a woman who has a strong voice, who has a lot of courage, and who's already spoken about things that you feel are wrong, try and empower other women around you. You know, that's the only way we can do this. This is a great battle. We've reached really far, but we are still not there, you know. And it's a very welcome change when I see, and I keep saying this, because in my life, there are so many men and there are so many boys in my family, my friends, that already don't believe in any kind of gender disparity. And I really hope that soon we see a world where there's no kind of discrimination at all, not just gender, but on any basis.
Correct. You mentioned that about off-screen, but on-screen within this movie, Soncharya itself, I think from the trailers that we've taken a notice of, it's the same. There are a lot of male protagonists over there, and you are like one feisty Indumati Tomar. Can you tell us a little about that role?
Well, as you said, it's pretty much a male-dominated film where the characters are concerned, because it is a dacoit drama. But then, while I was filming it, it honestly didn't matter, because everybody associated with this film, they are such evolved minds. You know, the film basically is a comment on patriarchy, it is a comment on gender discrimination, it is a comment on caste discrimination. And even though the film is set in 1975, everything that my director Abhishek Chaubey is commenting on is still very, very relevant. And that's why Soncharya is so special, you know. I love the fact that he's taken up an action-packed narrative to speak about these things. It's a very rare combination. But speaking about Indumati specifically, she is a woman who is so away from me, because, you know, I come from a family where I've really been empowered, I've been given the best education, given a lot of opportunities, given a lot of courage. Most of the times I operate from a lot of self-respect, pride and ego. But Indumati is somebody who hasn't seen this life, or she doesn't even know that this is an option. You know, she doesn't know that she can say no. She doesn't know that she has any kind of power. She doesn't even know that her living has any kind of impact to her existence. You know, she's lived under a ghoongat her entire life, and you know, she does some outstandingly courageous things in the film, but she doesn't know that she inherently has that kind of strength or courage. She's literally pushed into a corner because of which she takes these fantastic steps. And I mean, I've learned so much from her. She's full of love. She's this maternal person. She's intelligent. She's a survivor. And I think most women are, you know, we just have the knack to know. We just know how to survive, you know, in different situations, whether we have to manipulate to do that, we have to, you know, break any kind of shackles. It's just the way we've been constructed.
Absolutely. And knowing that we all blessed, grateful and privileged we are. And in that role, we came across a few research reads where it said that you, to don that character truly, you were walking barefoot for 2 months. I want to know how that journey was.
Well, I think this is the most amount of preparation I've done for any film, apart from Dam Laga Ke Hai Shab, where I was literally eating for a year. But apart from that, I think this character required that, and it just wasn't me. I think every cast member and every member of the crew has put in that much effort. But as I said, you know, this woman is very far away from me. I can't even imagine what her life would be for a character like Indumati in the 1970s. You know, it's too far-fetched for me. So I literally, you know, my day was around what her daily chores would be like. I'd kind of planned my workout around that as well. Because literally picking up 10 liters of water and like 10 kg bonies full of rice, walking around for kilometers barefoot, because that's what her life is like, and that's pretty much what I was trying to adapt. My director gave me such immense support, because literally, you know, from cooking on a chula to pisoing the chakki for hours just to get a few kgs of atta, it all sounded very easy to me. But when I actually started doing it, I realized that just at home, you know, when we say a housewife, we think, oh, their life is so easy. No, you know, these women, they run an entire little society within their family. You know, there is so much, there's a lot of physical labor, you know, there. And unfortunately, we don't give them a lot of love and respect, because we are like, oh, we don't, what do? You're just home. And that's just such a bullshit thing. When you actually, I really hope that at some point we have these men just run a house for an entire day, and then they'll realize it. And I've also realized it through my films and through the characters that I've done.
Knowing that, on a lighter note, if I had to ask you one dialogue that sticks with you and you've used it, that Indumati has said.
I think in the trailer, the dialogue's there as well. Ki hame kachu karo to goli maar dungi. I think every woman should just start saying it to any kind of crap that they come across.
Could I ask you to repeat that once more, like imitate in that character?
Of course. I'll try. Hame kachu karo to goli maar dungi. That was just brilliant. You do it so effortlessly. You know, it's very hard to say that, you know, oh, there's like so much effort put in and everything. You just like do it in a flow. Like, I want to know how that happens. What's your secret?
I don't know. Yeah, I just love what I do. And I put in a lot of hard work. And I put in a lot of thought. And I'm just very attached to my characters. Like, every time I finish a film, a bit of her is always within me. Because, these girls are so empowering, right? Their journeys are so unique and they're so brilliant. And I'm just like, oh my God, thank God I got an opportunity to play her. And with every passing film, I think I've become a nicer person. Because the amount of, I've just become more humble, more honest. And, you know, I've realized, and I have a lot of gratitude. Because the kind of struggles that women see around India and around the world, and where I was born and the kind of opportunities I've been given, I feel so grateful. And that's why I feel that it's kind of my responsibility to spread the awareness, to make sure that other women know what they can have.
Last quick two questions from our end. What's your favorite movie binge?
My favorite movie binge, I'm a bit of a, I love classics, so I think it's gotta be Casablanca.
And if I had to ask you one last, would be, how does Bhoomi Pednekar live the movie to the fullest? As not as an artist, but as a viewer of her own films, how do you live
movie? I can't. I every time I watch, actually, Sochita is probably the only time that I've not seen myself in cringed, because I'm so critical of my work that I'm and I love everybody else around me in the film, but I'm constantly like, oh my God, you could have done that better. So you can't really be very objective when you're watching your own film. Like, it took me about 30 times, and then the 31st time that I watched Dam Laga Ke Aisha, I said, okay, fine. You know, but yeah, I just completely lose objectivity. But as an audience, I watch every kind of cinema. I'm a very big supporter. I try watching most of them in theaters. And yeah, I like it all. I just love the movies.